Tales with UltraTV, and I'm here today with Nause, the DJ duo that is taking over the world. How is Miami treating you guys?
So good. It's the second time we're here for the Ultra, and it's been sick this week. I mean, last year we had a lot of just looking around, no shows, just like getting ready for this year. So
yeah.
This year's been amazing.
Can you tell us about some of the shows you played so far this week in Miami since you've been here for a week?
We've been here for a week, yeah, and we played shows at The Wall, Mokai, we played Bamboo, and today we're doing a show at the National, so we're really excited and couldn't ask for a better first like show.
Is this a place to experiment? Is this a place to kind of put something out there that no one might expect? And how has the reaction been so far?
We really want to try like everything, but still we're waiting for a lot of vocals for our tracks.
Yeah.
So that's one thing we're waiting for before we like play them the first time. But we played a lot of collabs we've done with a couple of people, and I mean the response has been amazing. So it's cool, like the people here are so into the music, so to be able to premiere stuff for them, it's the best place ever.
Yeah, absolutely. So one thing we want to talk about is obviously your vocals. The selection you guys have so far has been amazing. You've got a lot of support from the electronic community, obviously Tiesto, Chuckie, John Dahlback. Those are some huge names to have some support by. What did that mean to you, and how did that come across? Where were you when you first heard that people were remixing your tracks and pushing your content?
That was amazing to get those remixes on our first single. But Tiesto's been amazing from the beginning. Like we sent him some really, really early demos of stuff.
Yeah.
And I mean, he supported them and played them at his shows. And for us to find a YouTube video of him playing stuff, that was like the sickest.
What could we find on your iPod, let's say 5 years ago, 10 years ago?
10 years ago, it was definitely like more trancer stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
A lot of trance. Guy called DJ Mangu, and Fatso.
Oh damn!
So it was pretty hard trance, and we kind of like grow in, and then we find John Dahlback.
Yeah.
And he had so amazing old stuff.
Outside of electronic music, what are some of the artists or bands that you guys are into?
Queen.
Queen, of course. Amazing. Freddie Mercury is one of the best showmen on the planet.
That is so good.
You guys like fun? A lot of people that like Queen like fun.
I love fun, yeah. I've heard like split emotions about fun, but I fucking, they do the same like...
It's very theatric.
Yeah, and the same feel to it. So for me, yeah, I love fun stuff. Of course, Coldplay and... I kind of like Muse.
Of course. How could you not be? If you don't like Muse, you're mad.
And some, like, I love, like, the old school Swedish rap.
When did you realize that this was something you want to do for the rest of your life?
Just, like, in school, we did it for fun. And then people started hearing about it, and we showed our friends and stuff. And then all of a sudden, like, business-related people heard it. And, like, we thought it was just an hobby, and then... Of course, we want to work with music, and we always want to work with music, but like that's probably the point when we realize like that this may be able to like be a career.
And what song would you remix? What would the music video be like? And who would you team up with?
We always had a thing for Rock Your Body Rock by Ferry Corsten.
Oh, yeah.
And then all of a sudden, right, like we started making a new like edit of it.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden he posts like two remixes from Artie and like a month ago.
Yeah. It's like having your eye on a girl in middle school and you're like, I swear to God, I'm going to go up to her. I'm going to ask her to the co-rec dance, probably kiss her on the cheek, maybe the forehead, who knows. And then this jock comes in, swoops it, and he's like, I got two football players ready to take her out right now.
Captain America comes in.
Exactly.
Yeah. No, that's so that's pretty annoying, but still it's so much great music out there. I'm pretty much looking forward to Daft Punk's new album.
All right, so now we're gonna do some rapid fire questions. Best set you've ever seen in your life, go.
Probably Joakim Garou in Stockholm when we were like 18.
Funniest story that's ever happened to you on the road.
he passed out and I got locked out of our room in just my briefs.
Yeah. Are you serious?
And I was so.
Did funny. You not go to the front desk?
No, it was closed. So I actually tried, and
it was a small hotel with no like concierge or no, like people, no people were there. So, and you were so.
No, I sat down in the actual reception, trying to open drawers to find our key, because I really had to go to the bathroom.
What are some of the tracks that you're working on right now, and what's the sound we can expect?
We have a lot of new tracks. I think we have like four singles stuff, and then we have three collaborations.
Yeah, Mouth, an LA-based producer.
Nice.
Martin Garrix, a Dutch, like 16, 17-year-old guy.
Damn.
Who's amazing, and probably gonna do a track with Carly. So yeah, we're excited.
Starving the Backwell.
Yeah, two from Backwell.
Nice.
An electro duo based in Stockholm, and yeah, and those tracks are pretty much finished. Just like shaping it up for and scheduling the releases and stuff.
So serious question time. Top three comedy films ever, in your opinion?
Kung Pao.
Kung Pao, Enter the Fist?
Yeah.
That's got a cult following, man. Every single person I talk to at least mentions Kung Pao once in their top three or five.
Not at Roxbury.
Not at the Roxbury. Can we do it?
Yeah,
can we do it?
Sure.
Can we do it? Anyway, this has been Ultra TV with Nause. Hopefully you guys have an amazing trip. Thanks for taking the time. Thumbs
Thank
up.
You. Thumbs up. Double thumbs.
Double thumbs. Later.